guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, I'm Kenny. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel. I really appreciate that. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Today's video is gonna be another natural hair 101 talk. It's been a while I did a natural hair 101 talk, so I just want to get back into it because I know you guys really love my natural hair 101 series. So if you didn't know, my natural hair 101 series is where I talk about basic natural hair things to make your natural hair journey less stressful, easier. Talk about my own experiences. I share tips based on my own personal experiences, and also I talk about my experiences, my mistakes, things that I feel that I've done that is making my hair grow with less shedding, less setback, and all those things. So those are the things I talk about in my natural hair 101 series. I'll link the playlist, I'll link it in the description box below, and also I'll link it up here. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about three key things to having a less stressful, healthy, natural hair journey. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. Please, please, please make sure you subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate that. You can also press that bell beside the subscribe button so you are notified of my new uploads. Anytime I have a new video uploaded, you'll be the first to get the notification. I already did a video on my 8 tips, or my top 8 tips to facilitate your natural hair growth, which I'll link up here and also in the description box below. It's important that you check that video out as well. If you still need more help on your natural hair journey, I went into detail in a lot of things in that video, which you may find helpful. And if you want to see how I take care of my own hair personally, I'll link it up here as well on how I grow and care for my natural hair, and also in the description box below. You may want to check that out as well. So let's jump into today's video. The three key things that are important for a less stressful, healthy natural hair journey to grow long, healthy natural hair. The first one is patience. If you know me, I always emphasize on patience, patience, patience when you're growing your hair. My hair did not grow like this overnight. I started from relaxed hair, I grew my natural hair out, and then I big chopped my hair when my hair was at a length that I feel I could be comfortable in. Even though when I first big chopped my hair, I still was not comfortable with that length, but I learned to manage my hair, I learned to enjoy my hair at that TWA length. I made sure that I was enjoying my hair at that length. It motivated me to take care of it more, to do more things to it, and that way my hair started growing and growing and growing and growing. And this year may make it like 2 years since my big chop, and my hair is at this length now. The first thing that determines how your hair will grow, how thick your hair will be, how thin your hair will be, what your core pattern will look like, what your hair porosity will look like, it is your genetics. So you just have to embrace everything your genetics is giving you and be okay with it and be patient with your hair, and it will grow. That is just the basics. I would love my hair to grow as long as natural detainee's hair. I would love my hair to grow as long as Nephi Frofro, if you don't know, a fusion of color Leila. I would love my hair to grow as long as her hair, but my hair is not at that length yet. It's still at this length. So while my hair is at this length, I'm making sure that I'm enjoying it at this length. I wear my hair out 99.99% of the time, so I make sure I'm enjoying my hair journey without comparing my own journey to another person's hair. The second key tip that will make sure that you have a less stressful, very beautiful, enjoyable, healthy natural hair journey to facilitate your hair growth, make sure that you're having healthy long natural hair, is having a simple routine. That is the key. A working WORKING, a working simple routine for you. I always stress this and I'll continue to stress it. I don't follow other people's routine. I follow what works for my hair. I look for things that other people do and then I tailor it to my own hair. From when I big chop my hair to about 6 or few months after I did my big chop, there was no big difference in my hair length. But since I started having working routine for everything I do, my cleansing, my deep conditioning, my moisturizing, my night routine, I noticed a big difference in my length retention. I retain more length. My hair journey is like less stressful for me. When I meet people on the road and they tell me, oh, I can't manage natural hair, it's too stressful, I tell them it's not stressful for me. Like now, my routine is now simpler than ever than my routine used to be. My routine is now like simpler than ever. Like most, like you guys know, or most of you guys know, I wash my hair once in 2 weeks. I'm a very busy mom. I don't have much time to do my hair. Every weekend, I have a lot of things to do than doing my hair. Even Ade and Abila have shifted their routine to every 2 weeks as well. So if I wash my hair this week, the next week I'm washing Ade and Abila, the following week I'm doing my hair, and the following week I'm doing their hair. That way I'm not so stressed out doing all of our hair at the same time. That way I'm not so tired doing everybody's hair at the same time, because I really spaced it out. This is Nadia and Abila's week, the next week is mine, and the following week is theirs. Have a very good wash day routine, have a very good moisturizing routine, have a very good deep conditioning routine, a good night routine that ensures that your hair does not get frizzy, or you don't lose your curl definition easily, or that your hair does not get dry easily. All these things, they are important to make sure that your journey is not so tiring, because if you have a routine that you are used to, it's part and parcel of your life. You know that as you have to go to work on Monday morning, which is part and parcel of your life, you know that every maybe Friday evening, or every Saturday evening, or every Saturday morning, or every Wednesday morning, you have to wash your hair. And that is that, and it's gonna stick and it's gonna work for you. Look for products that make sure that your hair stays cleansed for a whole week or for 2 weeks. Look for products that make sure that, or that ensures that your hair stays cleansed, or that your hair stays moisturized for a whole week or for 2 weeks if you wash your hair every 2 weeks. The third tip is protecting your hair. Natural hair is not something that you want it to be all over the place every time. No, you want to find a way to protect your hair on wash days, after wash days, in between wash days. You want to find a way to protect your hair. I'm gonna tell you how I protect my hair. On my wash day, after cleansing my hair, after detangling, after deep conditioning my hair, after detangling my hair, I put them in hair bands. So if I now get out of the shower, if I decide to style my hair that day, I take my hair out of those hair bands. If I'm not styling my hair on that day, I leave my hair in those hair bands till when I'm ready to style or moisturize my hair. If not, my hair stays in those hair bands. That way, they are not all over the place. They are not shedding everywhere. They don't get tangled up again. I don't have to go through another episode of having to detangle my hair, which, as you all know, detangling natural hair is not so easy. If I'm moisturizing my hair, after moisturizing my hair, I don't just leave it like that to be all over the place. I either twist it or braid it or flat twist it. And that way I'm protecting it until when I'm ready to take out the twist or the braid or the flat twist for my curl definition, and my hair is not all over the place. When I take my braid out, or my twist out, my flat twist out, when I'm going to bed, I don't leave my hair like this to be all over the place. No, I take my hair bands again and I band my hair and I lay them and I keep them laid down flat on my head. And that way, my hair is not all over the place again. It's not shedding all over the place. I don't lose my curl definition. My hair stays moisturized for the days I want them to stay moisturized for, before I have to like re-moisturize it or rewash it or do anything I'm doing to it. Just know how you want to protect your hair. You want to do like long-term protective styles like braids, like box braids, or mallet twist, or crochet braids, or weaves, or wigs. Or do you want to keep your hair like protected, like with twists and braids and flat twists? Because those are the things that can make sure that you are protecting your hair. So that is that for today's Natural 101 series. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned one or two things from it. Like I always say, this is based on my own personal experiences and my own personal mistakes. That is what I share on my Natural Hair 101 series. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to leave me nice comments in the comment section below. I'll really, really appreciate that. Don't forget to share this video with whoever you think it's going to be of help to. You can share it on Google+, on Facebook, on Pinterest, anywhere you are, any platform you have that you think this video is going to be of helpful to people. Share it on there and I'll really, really appreciate that. Thank you guys, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.